You're on the move with Joanna, yours truly. We're going to be doing anywhere there's a chair workout. That's right. Believe it or not, you can get fit in a chair sitting down, chilling. Okay, maybe we can take the chilling part out, but you definitely can get fit sitting down. And just about everywhere we go, there is a chair. Work, home, church, it doesn't matter where you go. Park bench, go out, you know, sit down, read your paper, do a little bit of exercise. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off standing on the chair. These exercises are a little bit more intense, and we'll save the simple ones for later. We're going to do some music to this so you can have a little bit of fun. The exercise I'm getting ready to show you guys is a full body sculpting and toning exercise. You do not have to use a chair like this. You can use the front of the chair if this is too high. But what we're going to do is we're going to start off here. I'm kidding. Definitely not gonna do that. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna grab your weights. We're gonna start with the left foot forward. We're gonna use both feet, but we're just gonna start on the left foot this. You're gonna take your chair. Now again, this chair is kinda high. You can turn this chair around if you need to. That's too high. And use this part, like so. Bring that weight up to your shoulder. Bring it back down. I'm gonna do the high one. I kinda like the feel of getting my leg all the way over that chair. So again, I'm gonna plant that left. I'm gonna hold my weights here. We're gonna swing nice and high, bring it over, weights over, and take it back. Over and back. What is this doing? Working the waistline, quads, glutes, shoulders, back, chest. Okay, I'm gonna do four more. Nice and high. And I'm gonna do one more. All right. I'm gonna switch legs. I'm gonna plant my right now. And again, this is high part of the chair. Up and over. And again, you can just go up and over the seat. I'm gonna do three more. And one more. Okay, so that was right and left. Now let's do a combination, right and left. So we go right, take it back, left. So I'm dancing with the song. Talking and exercising. Two more. Last one. All right. So that's about the beginners of the hard part. The other part we want to do with a chair is isolating the upper body and like a Pilates move or a yoga move. So you hold here, make sure your arms are locked, and you hop, 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 hop. Now what this does is take that work up through the upper body on both sides, engage your cardio. Whereas a regular jack, first of all, involves so much impact, and you're not really getting that isolated sculpting and toning. So I'm gonna do 10 more of these. And the key is I gotta keep my hands down. Five more. Good job. So what I'm gonna ask you after this, did you die? You gotta get up and try. Get on the move. Start doing something. And that it doesn't kill you, you know it's gonna make you better. So that's the whole purpose of the shirt, is you did it, you sweated, you actually got through it, but you didn't die. So that's the key, is it's not gonna kill you. So just get up and get moving. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna have a seat. which is what most of us do while we're at the airport, watching television, at work at our desk, typing on a computer, or a dozen of other things. So one of the things we can do while you're at home on the couch is you can touch the back of your chair with your elbow, bring it back to the center, touch here, center. Center, always take that deep breath in, breathe out, inhale, breathe out, in, out, in, out, in, out. I'm gonna do five more on each side. Are you following me at home or are you just watching? Simple, sensible, sustainable. Start somewhere, start small, finish big. Two more. All right, last set. Perfect. I hope you guys like that. The next one we're gonna do is just simple bicep curls, but we're gonna add some cardio by pedaling. The pedaling mechanism while you're seated takes all of the impact away, but does not interfere with the intensity. So we're gonna come here, we're gonna pedal, pump and pedal. Biceps, biceps. Get you some good music, and you double up, double up, double up, and singles, singles, doubles, doubles, yeah. See, it looks like I'm just playing, but I'm telling you. I'm working my lower abs, quads, hams, biceps, and triceps when I push back down. So now I'm gonna put them together. Okay? If I wanted to add to this, I can add those shoulder presses. So now I'm doing a full body workout, cardio, sculpting, toning, right here. Now, if I wanna lose the shoulders or the biceps and go into delts, I'll go here. Up, push, down. Take it up, push it up, down. Down. So delts, shoulders, down. Delts, shoulders, down. Delts, shoulders, down. Okay. Right. So if you're doing this with me, I hope that you're sweating after all these episodes. Okay, so anywhere there's a chair, we're sitting. Our next exercise is gonna be involving the lower abs and the lower body, since we've just done quite a bit of a upper body move. We're gonna come here, find that seat. Do not lower until you know that you're over the seat, okay? So stretch your body all the way up. Sit down gently. No banging, no bouncing, but just real soft. Cheerleader stance up, wide sit down. Cheerleader stance up, and I'm breathing. And like I said, no less than 25, even if you have to break it up. You could do two sets of 10, one set of 5, one set of 10 and one set of 15. However you want to do it, just keep moving. I'm gonna do four more. And one more. Awesome. Good job. So there are a couple of more exercises I want to show you guys really, really quick. Some of my favorites. This is a comprehensive exercise that is signature super ab master. And what we do is we straighten our arms all the way up here like we would for a shoulder press, pull those knees up, stretch, squeeze, breathe out, in. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, Exhale. Now, if I change this move to advance, I'm going to stretch out, push it up. Stretch my legs, push it out. Inner thighs and quads, right here. I'm going to do four more. Three, two, and one more. Perfect. Again, going back, evicting that little pudge. We're going to hold on to the chair. Lift, 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 lift. Now, this is a slow pulling motion, like so, but there is an alternate one that's more of a tap, like here, like so. We just go up and down. And you go side to side with your music. Lean with it, rock with it. But all that's going to isolate through here. Or you can do your pull like so. Okay. One more exercise. And I'm going to go take me a little bird bath like I do when I go and train at lunchtime and get all cleaned up. Comprehensive again, coming from the chair, right, left, right, left. Signature ab master. Reaching for my toe, can't reach my toe, reach down. Can't do it with weights, tap the inner thigh, inner calf, grab here. Full body workout on these, seated in a chair. I love the fitness segment. It gets me ready and prepared for my 5-inch heels. I get to let my ponytail down. I get to tell you where I get all the strength and creativity and energy from when I get to sit down on the couch with my guests, sit down with you and talk to you guys one-on-one. But the reason that we do the fitness segment is because so many of us neglect our bodies and we just kind of let them go, let them go, let them go. We're getting older. Everybody's out of shape. We kind of just play into a absolute lie that we're supposed to lie around and do nothing about where we're going with this fitness. And I want to change that. And I also want to change and eliminate the idea that fitness has to be hard, it has to be aggressive, it has to be in a gym, it has to be all this over-sensationalized propaganda stuff. And I want to let you guys know, I'm coming back after this break, but I want to let you know, all of my help comes from the Lord. The joy of the Lord is my strength. And I'm going to share that with you right after this break. Welcome back to On the Move with Joanna Ward. I'm sitting here after my workout with one of the most amazing pastors that I've ever met in my life, Pastor James Mason. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you. The pastor of the Church in the Way, Pam's husband and my friend and pal. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory. Yes, hallelujah. Ma'am. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Yes, ma'am.
So, what I want you to do is tell our viewing audience about your story as yes, you matriculated, because you've been walking with the Lord for a very long time,
yes,
started
ma'am.
In ministry
yes,
at a ma'am. Young age. So start us from there, take us through the ministry, your testimony,
yes,
and
ma'am.
Then tell us a little bit about this Healthy Movement Challenge.
Yes, ma'am. Well, first of all, it's good to see you again.
You too.
Yeah, good to see
Thank you
again.
Thank you for joining us.
I'm honored to be on the show. Well, I've been in ministry now 26 years, mm-hmm. Started in 1990, did my first internship in Inglewood, California under Pastor John Emerson. And God has just blessed me through the years, you know. Since that time, I've been blessed to work with three amazing pastors, Dr. Ralston Mondesi, Dr. E. Dewey Smith, Jr., and Pastor Venable H. Moody here in Birmingham. And then just recently, 2 years ago, God called my wife and I to step out on faith and start a church. We called it the Church of the Way International. We began that church November 19th, 2014. So we're going into our 2-year anniversary.
Oh, nice.
And so last year I was actually installed, did the installation, you know, the traditional thing, the installation. And so 2014 was really both a good and a bad year for me. It was a good year in that I was being installed in the church that God allowed me to plant. But months later, I was installed, I think, March of 2014. But in May of 2014, I developed what they call ARDS in my lungs, and my lungs just literally shut down. Mm-hmm. I was in the hospital for 5 months, flatlined twice. Oh, wow. But God brought me back, mm-hmm. praise God. And so with that, being in the hospital 5 months, last year this time I was in a wheelchair. Now I'm walking on my own. And so God just, he miraculously healed me because all my medical reports literally said I was supposed to be dead. Yeah, even doctors, when they see me now, mm-hmm. they just sit there and look at me because according to science says that, hey, there's no way in the world he's going to make it through this. Mm-hmm. And so, but 5 months in the hospital, 2 months in therapy, almost 1 month in therapy. Now I'm back in the gym working out, back pastoring my church, and God really blessed our church and our family during that time because we had just started the church. Mm-hmm. I was installed in March. In May, I was gone for 5 months. But while I was gone, God blessed the church. The church kept doing ministry. And when I came back, believe it or not, I came back to a full church. People that I had never even met before, they came and they just connected with the vision. Mm-hmm. And so with all that, everything I went through last year, of course, last year I was like 439 pounds. Now I'm right at 275.
Oh, wow.
Praise God.
I
want to be under 200.
Yeah.
And so I'm working towards that. And so with that, God gave me a great idea that not only God said, do I want you to be healthy, I want you to teach your people how to be healthy. Mm-hmm. And so we started this healthy movement challenge. And it's a challenge, but it's not a 90-day challenge. It's not a 30-day challenge. You remember you actually spoke on one of our calls. Mm-hmm. It's a lifelong challenge. Mm-hmm. And the reason why we have these bracelets is that, of course, every time you look down at your wrist, you know, hey, I want to be healthy. And so with that, I've made a lot of lifestyle changes because the reality is I will never be 439 pounds again in my life.
Right.
And so I've made a lot of changes. And you can say that, mm-hmm. but if you say that but don't put action with that, mm-hmm. you will become that. And so I've made some serious changes, lifestyle changes. I have a trainer, mm-hmm. Hannah Bagwell. She trains me over at the 119 Club there in at the St. Vincent Health Center. I'm actually part of a clergy wellness program now.
Oh, awesome.
St. Vincent Hospital in Birmingham offered this program to clergy free of charge.
Oh,
and so they offer
wonderful.
You free trainer, free gym membership, mm-hmm. Free dietitian. I mean, everything mm-hmm. is free. Mm-hmm. So you have no excuses. And so what I'm trying to do is really lead by example. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people in my church have done well. We have members who've lost over 20, 30 pounds. But the Healthy Movement Challenge is not just a challenge for your health, mm-hmm. is we're challenging you to be healthy spiritually, financially, and physically. Those are the three areas mm-hmm. that we're focusing on. And so we're challenging people to be healthy spiritually, your walk with God. Mm-hmm. Not any religion, but your personal walk with God. Mm-hmm. I don't really believe in religion. I believe mm-hmm. it's about relationship,
right.
you know, with the Lord Jesus Christ. But then not only spiritually, but financially. Mm-hmm. You know, how are you doing financially? You know, mm-hmm. where are you financially? Because
right.
a lot of us are spiritually strong, but mm-hmm. we're financially weak.
Right.
Or we're spiritually strong, financially strong, but we're physically weak. And so bringing all those areas. Mm-hmm. And so what we do is we have a Healthy Movement Challenge call that meets every Wednesday at 8:30 p.m. Central Time. And we basically just give out information. Like you were on the call. Mm-hmm. We bring on people to present information that will empower people. Mm-hmm. Because what I found is that I think a lot of our people want to be healthy. We just don't have the knowledge.
Right.
And the Bible says that without knowledge, God says, my people perish.
Right.
And so I believe God has given me information that not only lead to my transformation, but that'll help somebody else. That, mm-hmm. that's what it's all about. So our whole church is on it. Mm-hmm. All right, so it's all about being healthy. Of course, you know, the Halloween, you know, yes, we had trunk and treat yesterday, so people right. gave out candy and everything. But what I'm learning is that everything, like the brother just said, is good in moderation.
Right.
You
right.
know, so I'm not this proponent of know this, know that,
right.
you can't ever do that again. Mm-hmm. I don't believe in that. I just believe in seeking God for wisdom mm-hmm. as to what I need to put in my body, mm-hmm. how I need to eat, like I pray about everything else,
right.
and being obedient.
Right.
You know, being obedient. So that's what it's all about. We have it on our website. We have a form that we ask people to go fill out. Their disclaimers there. Of course, you need to check with your doctor.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whenever you start any kind of health program, you want to check with your doctor
right.
and get that permission. But one lady told me she went and talked to her doctor. He said, what are we talking about here? Well, what kind of permission do you need?
Right.
Get on the program.
Right,
you know?
Right, right.
And so it's working. working. I mean, it's working. And like I said, it's not a 30-day, 90-day, 60-day, 120-day. No, I think that's where we've gone wrong.
Right.
You know, we'll do stuff for 30 days and see the results, celebrate that, and then go back to our ways.
Right.
And as the Bible says, only a dog returns to his vomit. And so once God has delivered us from this stuff, you know, we need to keep walking forward in the path that God has for us.
We really, really do. And that's an amazing story. And it's an amazing benefit because now we have this sensationalized, like you said, this religious format where God is Burger King. Have it your way.
That's right.
He's Santa Claus. Write out your list and let him do it.
That's right.
But when the faith is under fire is when we really see what it is.
Oh, yeah.
And to have walked through the valley of the shadow of death and feared no evil.
Yes, ma'am.
Knowing that God was not just with you, but with the family and the flock that he entrusted you with shows us just how near and dear our God really is. Because, you know, he doesn't forsake us and leave us when we're down.
No,
but,
ma'am.
You know, some of us think, well, if I go through a fiery furnace, that God is not with me. Or if I'm facing a lion's den, that God is not with me. But I beg to differ. I know that I know that I know that faith is that thing that anchors you in the midst of great storms and turmoil and gives you the strength.
Yeah.
To trust God.
That's right.
And it's a training. Like, I'm a trainer. You know that. You trained me before.
Yes, ma'am.
And we have to be trained to trust God. And the trials do that for us.
That's right.
It birthed things like this.
That's right.
It birthed this types of testimony. In Revelations 12, it says what? We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. And you are a living, breathing, walking, talking testimony for anybody who believes that God is not able to do exceeding abundantly above all that he can you get after things.
I share with people, Joanna, that up until last year, I really preached about a God I'd heard about.
Mm-hmm.
But now I preach about a God that I know.
Okay.
Because for literally 2 months, I had no voice. I couldn't even talk. So I literally, for 2 months, had to mouth everything. And so what God whispered to me, he said to me, you need to start speaking what you believe.
Mm-hmm.
And so for 2 months, while I was in the hospital, I mean, the first 2 months, I would literally mouth once I woke up out of that coma for a month and a half, I'm coming out of this alive.
Mm-hmm.
That was my daily testimony. People come in, my mom, my dad, other people, and my mom would be like, what is he saying? My wife, Pam, she was there. Oh, my God, Pam was just so wonderful through this whole ordeal.
Mm-hmm.
Pam said, he's saying he's coming out of this alive.
Being your voice, bone of your bone, flesh of your flesh, voice of your voice.
Doctors would come and I pulled them to the bed before they walked off because I would hear what they were saying.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a matter of time now. And I remember one time they called my family in. I pulled it back to the bed and I mouthed that to him.
Mm-hmm.
I'm coming out of this alive.
You got to speak.
And 2 months and sure enough, here I am now.
Here you are.
I literally, God has led me to go back to the UAB hospital there in Birmingham on several occasions. I walk in there and one nurse, one time she literally almost passed out.
Because she couldn't believe her eyes.
Because she said, wait a minute. No, you are not the guy that was in this bed. No, that's not you. And my wife said, yes, ma'am. And I said, Miss Mason, you look familiar. And she said, this is a miracle.
It is absolutely.
She said, this is a miracle. And so God really, I mean, God took care of our church.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we had just planted the church.
Right.
Normally, what I'm told is, my spiritual father told me, normally when it happened, a pastor being gone for 5 months, that church folds, that church dies. But no, it didn't. Our church kept doing ministry. We kept feeding the hungry, clothing the naked, taking care of the sick. And when I came back, you know, and the great thing about the whole deal is my spiritual father, Dr. E. Dewey Smith, he's one of our overseers of the ministry. He actually took over the church, you know, while I was out and literally sent his ministers down. God bless them.
Mm-hmm.
Minister of Hope at House of Hope Atlanta, sent them over every week for five months, every Sunday, every Wednesday, teach and preach to our people. And so God just really showed himself strong and mighty. In the midst of everything I faced, he took care of me. He took care of my family. My family didn't want for anything.
Mm-hmm.
Every bill was paid. And nobody in the house had a job. You feel what I'm saying?
I hear you.
Every bill was paid. My children were taken care of. The church was good. We were still receiving a salary from the church.
Right.
With less people.
Mm-hmm.
And so what God showed me was that I'm in charge.
Mm-hmm.
I got this. And it really became clear when I was tripping about it, because I mean, I didn't wake up like, oh, God, thank you.
I'm so glad
to literally be paralyzed.
Right.
I was paralyzed.
You were like, what's going on?
I said, God, I'm really concerned about the church. I'm really concerned about my family. He said, let me ask you one question. I said, okay. Whose is it? Whose is it? I said, it's your church, God. He said, whose family is it? It's your family, God. He said, well, check this out. Anything that belongs to me, I take good care of it. You relax. And after that, I was good.
You
were
like, okay,
God. So here
I am,
the pastor of a church that I just started.
Right.
Could not be there for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But even through that, once I woke up and got my voice back, I was even counseling people on the phone while I was in the hospital.
Like, you're praying with people. 20,
yeah.
2.5 decades.
Yeah, and so God has just been, he's just been awesome, Joanna. I mean, when I was here with you, we walked up and down Stone Mountain, I knew about him.
Mm-hmm.
But now I know him.
Amen. Amen.
For myself.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much for coming
Praise
and joining
God.
Us and sharing your
Praise
ministry,
God.
Your testimony about the challenge. The website is going to be there.
Yes,
Let
ma'am.
Me explain something to you all, dear beloved. Nahum 1:7 says that God is a good God, and he's not just a good God
Man.
When it's going good, but he's a stronghold in the day of trouble,
Man.
And he knows those who are trusting in him.
Yes.
So if you're trusting in God, he already knows that. And he's going to take care of you. I love the testimony Amen. Of Pastor James Mason, which is why he's here. And it's so deep that God steps in even when you think that you're out. That's why God has to be large in charge and in control of
Amen.
Everything that we do. Keep it in God's hands. Go with God and you can't go wrong. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Don't lean into your own understanding. Acknowledge him in everything. So even when you're out of the variables, God is still large in charge and in control. I'll see you guys next time.